y'all. All y'all came in smiling. It just made my day a whole lot better. Before we start, I'd like you to pick up an object near you that you don't mind being away from for a little bit. Just hold it up in the air once you have it so I can see that everyone has one. Me, it's my phone. You know, just hold it up in the air, right above you. This is going to represent a judgment, worry, or worry about being judged you may have inside you. Just kind of, just throw it over there, put it on the ground, whatever you need to do. Now, before we start, I just want to tell y'all something kind of funny to me. Leading up to this, I have been like kind of nervous. And if y'all know, I have two dogs, Nevo and Tuff. And they're the sweetest little things. They're Bichon Poos, and they're just really tiny and great and cuddly. And so for the past week, I've just been preaching to them. And let me tell you, they've been praising the Lord. So now we got some Christian dogs at our house. So I'm going to read y'all some scripture, and today I'm going to talk to y'all about kindness and forgiveness. And yeah, so Ephesians 4:32. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other just as Christ forgave you. So today in our world, we're not like that. We're not. One day, I was at school, and I was having a conversation with one of my friends. And I said, you know, in the Bible, it says we should all be kind and try to be just like Jesus. And they said, well, no one's going to be just like him. It's impossible. And I said, well, we have to try. And we have to. I don't know about y'all, but I think just raise your hand if you've ever done something mean to someone. Like, you've been stressed and you've taken it out on someone. You've talked bad about someone behind their back. You've done something very, very rude. I'm not trying to be rude, but everyone in this church should be raising their hands because it is nearly impossible. Now, I'm going to share y'all a little life experience that I have. It's about taking digs at people. Now, I'm a cheerleader, okay? Most of you all know this. I stand on the sidelines, I'm cheering, you know, go Indians, let's go, let's score that touchdown. When all of a sudden, I hear this, and it breaks my heart into pieces. I hear someone yelling something about my father. Now, as much as I want to yell back, no, you don't know him. I mean, this is the man that literally had The Little Mermaid memorized when I was little. I mean, like, knew it by heart because we watched it so many times together. And people are yelling bad about him. Personally, as a daughter, I want to fight back, yell back, say mean things. But now I step back, I empty those thoughts from my mind because that's not what Jesus would do. It's not. And Jesus would not take digs at people who take digs at us. He would forgive them, which is a good thing, because we need to forgive. That's what he wants us to do. That's what he needs us to do. We need to be compassionate and forgiving. When we went to camp, they gave us these little balls. And on this ball, we had to write something that we were going to leave the camp. Not like, oh, you know, me and Susie, we went and we climbed up the mountain and we took selfie. No, it was something that you were going to forgive, let go, leave there forever. Me, I wrote it down on the ball, but I couldn't let it go. I couldn't. I didn't want to leave it at camp. I was so scared of someone reading it, someone knowing my business, and just, I couldn't let it go. It was so deep embedded into my brain that I could not let it go. So we had to give our volleyball bags back, and I had been using that as my school bag. And I used an old backpack that I found in my closet. It had the ball in it, because it was the backpack I took to camp. I looked what I wrote on there. It was so stupid. So dumb. I had completely forgotten about it. Completely. 100%. Gone. Out of my mind. And I thought, wouldn't it have been so much easier to take that off my chest, leave my heart without so much worry, and now I regret that very much, very much. And it just bugs me that I didn't let it go. Now I want to talk to y'all about a cycle. Not the water cycle, not the carbon cycle, the nitrogen cycle, none of those. A cycle of hate, of unkindness. In this cycle, you've got people walking around. Someone has a bad day, and then they go, and I give a bad day to Calista, because it was my bad day. I get angry, I take it out on Calista. Calista takes it out on Natalie. Natalie takes it out on Jordan. Jordan takes it out on Chris. It's an unending cycle. And as much as we would like to admit that we are not in the cycle, we are. We have all hurt someone. We have all done something so mean they probably scarred that person for life. I don't know your lives. I really don't. I barely know some of you. But I know that everyone has been in this cycle, whether we like to admit it or not. So, I don't know about y'all, but I love Raising Cane's. I love the sauce, the chicken fingers, oh my gosh, the french fries, Pringle cut. So, what if there was another cycle? I'm bringing the Cane's into this in a minute, but what if there was another cycle? Okay, whole new cycle, a cycle of kindness. An infinite wave, just like the mean one. Okay? That's our Cane's. We want that so bad, because it's free and it's Cane's. I mean, it's Cane's. Okay? And so we're over here, we're in the cycle, we got our heads down, we're just so depressed, we're making other people miserable too. And to me, we're like, that is the devil's cycle. He loves it. That's his little game. That's his board game that he plays with his friends. He loves it. That's his little baby. But we look over and we see that Cane's and we're like, that'll be a change. I'm gonna try it. So as we're taking steps closer and closer and closer to the point where we can almost taste it, he brings us back. Right to the cycle. Now, this is from us being mean, talking behind each other's back. Something happens. Whenever we're coming closer, the devil, he goes through people to us. So we need to remember that we need to be kind. Because whenever we're not kind, we're playing his little game. Do y'all really want to keep playing his little game the rest of your lives? I know I don't. That's a miserable life right there. Miserable. Pathetic. Horrible. Why do we want to stay in this spot? It's going to be a hard fight, but we're going to come to this Cane's. We have to. We have to come to the Cane's. If we don't, it's just not going to be right. So, whenever, as I was saying before about taking digs at people, let's say Thomas is a good friend of Janie. Okay? Now, Janie is moving closer to Christ, okay? She's walking along, trying to get back in the good cycle. Then Thomas goes behind and talks behind her back. She hears word about it, and she tries to go back and get right back at him, telling all his secrets. We can't do that. We can't. It's not what Jesus wants us to do, and it's what we're doing now. Now, even if we're trying to go to the cycle, it can be camouflaged. You know what I mean? It can be like, it's not really there. Because we start, he realizes that we're going here. And then it comes to the point where it's, what if I make them think that they're going here, but really they're just doing it for themselves? We can't do kindness to get recognition. We can't. So I'm going to tell y'all a story about a drawbridge. Once there was a man, and he worked a drawbridge, okay? So he would switch the train tracks. So when the train would come, they would go over the bridge. The man, he took his son to work one day. Okay? His son was playing around. He didn't know where he was, really, because he was so busy. The train was coming about 15 minutes away. He yelled for his son to come back. No answer. No one came. Train was 5 minutes away, no one came, then he saw the train. Then looked on the bridge as he was about to turn it, and he saw his son. There was not enough time for him to run across or run back. So, there were millions of people on the train, and his one son. He didn't know what to do. He loved his child with all of his heart. They knew that all those people were on that train. So he said, "God forgive me," and he pulled the switch. The train killed his son, but all those people lived. He looked on that train and he said, "All those people will have no idea what I just did." In this case, even if it's just we picked up trash in the park, no one's gonna know what we did, but God will. God's gonna know what we did. We should not be doing this for ourselves. We should be doing it for God, for our community. So I don't know about y'all, my family, we like a good challenge. I mean, my dad's a football coach, my granddad's a football coach. We like challenges, games. I'm giving y'all a 14-day challenge. I wanna see if y'all can do it. We all know Kiwanis, Texas, okay? Pretty town, nice town, but it is a mean town at the same time. Okay? 14 days, I would like y'all to do something kind every day, anonymously. Just trying to get to the cans a little bit further. Okay? So what do y'all think? You think you can do it? Because let's say that everyone in this town, they're going through this cycle, okay? Everyone in this town is going through that cycle. If we pull, how many people would you say are in this church? Can I get an estimate? Anyone? 150, 125? That's a good amount, you know? Good amount. We have a small town, we can do it. So if we pull all 150, 125 to this cycle, don't you think that that's going to leave a gap in the other cycle? People are going to start following those people, using them as an example, looking for their peers. So they're going to start going too. And then after that, everyone's just going to be oozing out Jesus. And if we, our little town can ooze out Jesus, it's going to spread to Childress, Kroll, Chillicothe, everywhere. Maybe even the whole United States. But someone has to start it, so I think our church can. So, questions, I'll be up here. Please bow your heads and pray with me. Lord, just thank you for everything you've done today. Thank you for bringing us all together. And just, Lord, help us with our 14-day challenge. Help us be more kind, compassionate, and forgiving. And to not dig at people, to dig at us. And just to help us live a happy life and help us ooze out Jesus so we can make a difference in someone's life and bring them to you. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen.